Vaughn, you're in Phoenix, Arizona. Also, we should note a place that you know well, considering that you grew up there. Also, the race is tight. We've heard a lot about the focus on Latino and Latina voters that could help turn Arizona blue. At the same time, you hear the term red wave getting thrown around. Talk to us about that.
Yeah, Hallie, the big demographic I think that we're going to be looking at here tonight are independent voters, because polling has consistently showed the president down anywhere about 20 percentage point among independent voters after winning them in 2016, and they make up about one third of the electorate. So with the president expecting a deficit of support among independents, it turns into the question about turnout on the Republican and Democratic side. And so far, what you have seen compared to 2016, Hallie, is that Democrats have far outpaced Republicans in terms of returned ballots. But that's where it comes down to today. I was talking with some Republican officials here in the state that said, expect that red wave today. And so far, we are seeing by a 3-to-1 margin, Republican voters coming out here to the polls in person today. At the same time, you are talking about literally this election coming down to potentially hundreds of votes, thousands of votes. And that's why it's important to talk to folks like Norris, who I want to introduce everybody to. Because Norris, you were one of those voters that didn't vote in 2016, you were telling me. But this time, it's different. Why?
Well, I would say I wasn't really exposed to much information back then. I kind of just throughout my life have voted for whoever my parents told me to vote for, or my school, my teachers, or community, or even just who I thought I should vote for based on what I look like even. And this is the first year that I've really got to think for myself, be exposed to both sides, hear things all around, and really form my own opinion and make my own decision. I feel like it's important now more than ever because of, I mean, with young people, they're either listening once again to celebrities or to their parents and not really forming their own opinion. But I think now with such a rise in social media and people even being aware now of such censorship too, that people want answers, right? So I feel like I've been able to ask those questions and get the answers I want and come out here and vote.
Norris, thank you very much. Hallie, Norris and voters, you know, we've already seen 2020 levels exceed 2016 totals already here in the state. And that has to do with the fact that Democrats and Republicans, voters that didn't come out in 2016, are out at the polls here today, Hallie.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.